This holiday season, a lot of people are online shopping. It's super easy and convenient to do, but you have to be careful. There's a lot of sites out there, and you really have to protect your information. Today, I have Lori Putnam with Ameris Bank to talk about ways to prevent fraud and all that cyber crime that happened. Welcome, River City Live. And let's start out. You have a personal story, correct?
I do. My dad, my sweet 81-year-old father, was recently an attempted fraud victim. And we did not let it happen. He uses his cell phone to do nothing except make calls, receive calls. He's not connected, no online, no email, no nothing. But got a phone call from somebody purporting to be my nephew in jail for DUI and needed $5,000. So that's the adrenaline rush.
Yeah.
My dad's really just, what do I do? And so he called me and we verified that this was not in fact true. And he said something after it that really made me think. And what he said was that I didn't think so because it didn't really sound like his voice. And that was the thing with that. Even if you're not connected, you can still be a victim. But if that something isn't quite right, check it out, investigate it.
Absolutely. And then, you know, when you talk about, let's say, being online, there's so much of our information that's out there. Mm. So that's why, in this case, your dad, his cell phone number was somewhere that somebody grabbed, right, that was out of his normal network. So when it comes to really being online, what are some things that we can do to protect ourselves and our identity?
So you have to be careful and you have to be aware. And you have to understand that, especially this time of year, this is high season for fraudsters. They are really enjoying themselves right now because we're in a hurry, we're not paying attention, we're rushing around, we're pushing to get this and looking for the perfect gift and running out of time, and now Christmas is, what, a week away or whatever? And so you have to really make sure that the sites you're visiting are secure sites. And the easiest way to do that is to check the web address. And if you see HTTPS in that web address, then you can feel comfortable that you're dealing with a safe, secure site. But if you check the web address and you only see HTTP in there, chances are the site's not as secure as it should be, or you could be dealing with a fraudulent site. You do not want to give somebody your information who is going to use it to do evil and not good.
Wow, so something as easy as just making sure that S is in there on the top, that's gonna help you out.
S equals secure.
Wow, okay, so that's a good note. I did not know that. And I feel like what you said is so true. Everybody's so busy right now. And again, all of our information is just sitting there online. It's easy
it
to
is.
Pick.
And it's really almost scary when you think about it because all of our information is sitting out there online. And we get, in my industry, in the banking industry, we see things all the time. IRS calls you up and says, if you don't pay me right now, we're going to, you know, come and take your house. The IRS isn't going to call you and use those kind of methods to collect a debt.
And that's pretty timely right now, too, because people are starting to get their W-2s or their 1099s to start that process up. And that's a good note. And every year we remind people they don't do that.
No.
And they don't email either. It's always really by a letter, you know, to do their correspondence with them. Now, what about traveling? This time of year, a lot of people are doing traveling, you know, maybe even just by car. But there's a lot of things you have to watch out for.
So I tell people, travel, pack lightly. Your credit cards may have worked really hard this year, but they don't deserve the vacation that you do. So just take a couple of them, okay? And when you take those couple cards, make sure that the primary card you're using isn't your debit card. If your card is compromised, you could be financially devastated. So using a credit card gives you a little bit more protection than a debit card does. And if your credit card gets compromised, having a backup doesn't leave you stranded. Lock the cards up if you're not using them in a safe in your hotel room or in the hotel safe. Verify your activity. If you give your card to a waiter to go and run a tab for you, that card's out of your sight. You should never let your cards out of your sight. But if it's out of your sight, then be proactive and just check your activity and make sure. And don't use your debit card. That's the most important thing. I don't use my debit card when I'm traveling unless I take it with me because I may need cash, but it's not my primary source of payment. You can also set up text alerts, and your credit card company can text you if you either have a transaction that is done without the card present, or if something exceeds a certain limit, you can set up text alerts for virtually anything with your credit card company. So then you would know.
These are all great tips, and it's interesting because really you're utilizing technology for yourself to help against bad technology out there with all these alerts and things like that. You can kind of customize how you want it done. So if you want to learn more, go to AmerisBank.com. Great resource, a lot of information. And thank you for all your time and your information. We appreciate it.
Thank you.